Over the last 70 years, average global life expectancy has increased by more than 25 years. And while scientific and social advancements have allowed us to live longer, we aren't necessarily living healthier. Age-related chronic disease has an impact on nearly every person over the age of 60, and diseases associated with aging have huge human and economic costs. Now, doctors and scientists around the world want to combat the health challenges of getting old by combating aging itself. Most of the research around health and aging is focused on lifespan, how long you live. The average global lifespan is currently 73 years. But a newer area of study focuses on health span, which is the period of your life that you are generally healthy, when you don't have any serious or chronic illness. It focuses on the quality of your life rather than just the length of your life. According to data collected by the National Institutes of Health, the average health span is 64 years. And as you can see, the average lifespan being about 73 years, you've got a health span gap where most people spend the last 10 years of their lives or so in poor health. Now, as we age, our body undergoes changes. A whole variety of factors, from our genetics to the food we eat, the amount of daily stress we encounter, and where we live. All of that contributes to the aging of every single cell in your body at varying speed. You can literally see it happen under a microscope. And there's a long list of diseases that are directly associated with the biological aging of the body, like inflammation, Alzheimer's, physiological decline. But top scientists around the world believe that by targeting the biological aging of our bodies, not the diseases themselves, most age-related diseases and ailments can be prevented, if not slowed or put off by years. So addressing health span would not only improve the quality of life for millions of people, it could have a major economic impact. Currently in the United States, people over the age of 65 account for about 17% of the population, but are responsible for 38% of our national health care costs, spending nearly five times the amount we spend on infants nationally per day, according to the NIH. The science on addressing health span and combating aging is emerging, but it's very new. And with the global population above 60 set to double to more than 22% of the world by 2050, there's huge individual societal and economic incentives out there for us to figure this out soon. Enter XPrize HealthSpan. Now, XPrize raises money to design massive competitions, competitions that have multi-million dollar prizes, to incentivize teams from around the world to come up with innovative solutions to some of the world's biggest challenges. The funds are raised through a mix of big and small donors and corporations individually for each prize. I should tell you, I'm on the board of trustees at the XPrize Foundation. It's an unpaid role. Last month, XPrize launched its newest and biggest competition yet, XPrize HealthSpan. It challenges teams to develop therapeutic treatments that target biological aging rather than disease. The $101 million prize will go to the team that develops a therapeutic treatment for seniors that in 1 year or less can restore muscle, cognitive, and immune function by a minimum of 10 years, with a goal of 20 years. And the teams are going to have 7 years to do it. Mark your calendars. Joining me now to discuss this is Dr. Jamie Justice. She's the Executive Vice President of the Health Domain at the XPrize Foundation. She's a professor of internal medicine at Wake Forest University School of Medicine, and she focuses on aging and geroscience. Dr. Justice, good to see you. Thank you for being with us. This is a very exciting one, so I want to ask a number of questions that I know my viewers are very interested in. This is a $101 million prize. The prize goes to a team that develops a therapeutic that restores muscle, cognitive, and immune function by a minimum of 10 years. The goal is 20 years, and it's the target group is people aged 65 to 80, and they got 7 years to figure this out, right? Is that roughly right?
You've gotten it exactly right, Allie. Thank you so much for allowing me to be here to talk about it. It is an absolutely audacious but really exciting prize. I couldn't be happier to lead it.
How did you come to these benchmarks? One of the things that folks who don't know XPrize maybe don't know is that there's always a benchmark. There's a big prize, and it's a good prize, but you have to meet very specific things. And it has to be audacious, otherwise someone will have done it already. But you have to believe that it's attainable.
Yeah, so that's exactly right. So I've been working in this field, my entire career has been, and it's an emerging field, we call it geroscience, but looking at the biology of aging as possible target for therapeutic development. And the goal here is really not disease-based. And so we were very specific in this award and in its and in the mechanics of it, is that those three functions, we're not specifically looking at any one disease treatment. What we're really looking at is improving function and functions that are really important to people to stay active, to stay engaged. You know, the things that we like and value so much throughout life, and especially as we get older, is the ability to maintain our physical function, being able to walk and stay fit, maintain our cognitive abilities so that we can interact with others. We remember that grocery list when we go to the store, and we just lived through a major international pandemic. I think we can all really value how important it is to have a healthy and resilient immune system so that we can actually go out and meet the world's challenges as we exit our house and interact with others. These are the cornerstones of staying fit, productive, and part of a really growing aging community, which, again, aging is a beautiful thing. We have an aging population, and that's filled with really incredible optimism and really great promise and opportunity. But we have to have solutions so that we can maximize the years that we're given.
So one of the problems, I mean, I don't know if it's a problem at all, but in my entire life, the concept of dealing with disease has been hyper-specific, right? Whether you're thinking about a type of cancer, a very specific type of cancer, or diabetes or heart disease, people fundraise that way, the studies go that way, you target that learning. It's siloed. I didn't even know there was another way to do it. I just assumed that's what we do. We target all these diseases and eventually we live longer and healthier. Why this different approach? Why aging as opposed to disease?
So you've just nailed it exactly. And so this is the major misconception, is that when we start talking about aging, people automatically think we're talking about immortality. And really, we're talking about very practical solutions for a very real problem. And that's exactly it, is that the number one predictor, the major risk factor for any disease, major chronic disease, is age. And so there have been really incredible modeling work that's been done by J. Olshansky and many others that have shown that if you actually do target and cure individual diseases, the net benefit on a population level is actually not that great. And so if we actually take the reverse perspective and start looking at our biological aging, which is actually just another way of studying health and life, if we can really look at some of these fundamental mechanics and these fundamental processes, we begin to find new solutions both for existing diseases that are really difficult to treat and target on their own, but then also the converse is we find ways to actually improve health across multiple diseases, or again, really what we're interested in it says that aspect of health that's more than any disease. And so if we can find ways to optimize and really improve that quality, I think the benefits to society, both to the individual and to society, are much greater. So this is the real genesis of a field.
There's an interesting, you used some language that was interesting. We're not talking about curing things. In fact, the prize talks about restoring functions, not even necessarily prevention. Can you just explain to me? Because if that's how our future is going to look, I want to understand what restoring function means versus prevention versus cure.
You're right. And it's not really that there is one yes and the other no. It's not a binary. It's that these things often, they go tandem. And really for us, the prizable part, because remember, this is not just a trial. We're actually getting our scientists, getting investigators, getting our public to really start talking about this, is we assume this aging process is inevitable. And so this gives us a new language where it's not going to be one or the other. In fact, these solutions that we can show in the short term within 1 year in a very prizable way, we can show an improvement in 1 year, then those are probably going to be the things that are going to be have the largest effects on prevention when we start talking about those sort of more clinical disease outcomes. And if we can show improvements in function that are really central to a whole host of different diseases and not diseases, are just a way to actually interact and be part of our life, then I think that even when we're talking about prevention, those are probably going to be the earliest signals that we're going to get for things that can actually extend what we think of as more of a disease-centric sort of health span. So how do we prevent multiple diseases? And some of them, as I mentioned before, have also had really great use, giving us new therapies therapeutic opportunities for existing very difficult to treat diseases. So the impact is multiplicative. And so there's a lot of ways that this could be really useful across. So it's not that we're not interested in disease, but this prize in particular is prioritizing health and prioritizing function and that aspect of health that is more than any one disease process.
I'm booking you right now for, what is it, 7 years from now? Is that when we have our deadline?
Actually, Ali, come along for the ride. So one of the really great things is that, yes, this is a long prize because running trials takes time.
Yeah, yeah.
But we have multiple endpoints. Is we're going to be engaging scientists now. We already have almost 100 teams that have signed up just in the last week. We're going to have early research and development opportunities. There's really great ways for people to get involved. They're going to have clinical trials across the world. This is a global competition. And we would love for you guys to join us on the ride. There's incredible people.
Count me in. I think you're going to hear from a lot of my viewers as well. Jamie, good to see you. Dr. Jamie Justice is the Executive Vice President of the Health Domain at the XPrize Foundation.